going to get the lead into turn one. It's going to be a very interesting one indeed. Let's see. One light. Two lights. Three lights. Four lights. Five lights. And for the first time in Bahrain, it is go! And look at Ricciardo! Great start from Daniel Ricciardo! I think he might have taken the lead! Ricciardo, a great start from the Aussie! Vettel has not had a brilliant start, he's already been jumped! He looked like he got bucked down at the start! Down into turn one! Who's gonna lead? Into turn one! Is Ricciardo gonna get the lead off Hamilton? Side by side to go! I think Hamilton's took him! Yes, he has Hamilton in the lead! Oh, there's a bit of crashing going on in the background! I think there's a bit of contact, it involved one of the Eldorados! What happened? What happened? It involved Valtteri Bottas. What on earth happened? Let's have a look. Let's see if we can ride on board with him. Let's see. So he gets clipped from the back by... Oh, Van Dorn got spun around, look. Van Dorn got spun around. And he hit the side. Luckily, no damage to Van Dorn. But that was a terrible start. I think Bottas got hit by someone. I don't know who. But Bottas got hit by someone. And it... Oh, there, look. It started off with Verstappen who hit Van Dorn and then he hit Bottas and that's when Van Dorn started spinning around. And as a result, well, that happened. And that lifted Alonso. Well, he dropped back now because everyone was trying to avoid... Oh, he even hit Massa! Oh, that was not nice from Alonso, was it? He's hit Massa off. Let's have a look on board from him, his perspective of it. So, he got hit as well. From the back, luckily he didn't get taken out. Vettel's there, look. Then those who come charging by, and then he didn't expect Massa to turn across him, and then he just hit Massa off. So, Massa, that could just be deemed as a racing incident because Alonso did not see him. But look at the battle for the lead now. Ricciardo trying to retake the lead from Lewis Hamilton, and Hamilton just holds him off. In the end there then, so a chaotic start indeed, Vettel trying to regain the positions back, but not quite, wasn't able to get the position of Wehrlein again, and as a result, Hülkenberg is now all over the backside of Vettel, Alonso in 7th after a little bit of contact with Massa at the start, but luckily for him, he was able to gain off the start, as Massa is now rejoining last, so luckily, despite the chaotic start, nobody has retired on the first lap, which is good. Meantime, the top three streaking away. Hamilton leads, Ricciardo second, Perez third, with Wehrlein fourth, Vettel in fifth, with Hülkenberg sixth, Alonso seventh, and Newgarden rounding out the top eight at the moment, but the top three keeping themselves on it at the moment. Hamilton leading the race after what has been a tricky season for him. He ends up leading here in Bahrain, but he's got Ricciardo and... Sergio Perez for company. Yet again, Perez, he's been battling with him throughout the first two races, back on his case yet again, as he now go around the double left-hander, down the pit straight, the support pit straight we go then. And as you can see, Wehrlein holding off Alonso for the moment. There's a little bit of argy-bargy in the background. I think one of the Bud Light Lime Motorsport cars went wide. I think it was Simon Pagenaud who went wide, going through that corner there, and as a result, he's put him into the clutches of Kevin Magnussen. Sorry, it was actually Magnussen and Rossi have actually got past. Who was that? It was Pagenaud. So Pagenaud made the mistake going through there. I don't know if you just saw that in the background, but one of the Bud Light Lime Motorsport cars went off in the background. And at the moment, Hamilton leads here in Bahrain with Ricciardo in second place. Perez is in third and trying to find a way past Ricciardo. It seems that he has the quicker car compared to Daniel right now. Daniel had a very good qualifying session, as we said, as they now come down the pit straight as we come to the end of a chaotic lap one there. So Hamilton leads, Ricciardo second, Perez third, Wehrlein fourth, as Hamilton sets an early fastest lap of the race as now, because he's got the clear track in front of course, Wehrlein fourth, Vettel fifth, and then it is Hülkenberg sixth, Alonso tucked up behind him in seventh, and Newgarden rounding out the top eight. Perez wasn't able to try and find a way down into turn one, wasn't able to get the lunge on him as he just go around turn one there then. So at the moment, Alonso looks to be on a lighter fuel though compared to all of these guys right now, as Hamilton actually seems to be the lightest of everyone, so that could explain why he's getting away from Ricciardo right now, because at the moment Ricciardo's having to fend off Perez right now, who's currently in second place right now. So a brilliant start from Lewis, a terrible start from Sebastian Vettel, getting bugged down at the start, and now he's got to make his way through the field yet again. He was the best of the rest last time out in Brazil, and he wants to continue that here in Bahrain. They now approach turns 10, 11, and 12, as we now ride on board with Sergio Perez as he comes down towards turn 12, using all the curb that's on the left. He's trying to dispose second place off Daniel Ricciardo. And as they now approach the hairpin, through the hairpin we go then, as they now approach the double left-hander. Let's see, so through the double left-hander we go then. And Hamilton getting away from these two at the moment. Meantime, Alonso all over the backside of Hülkenberg, wanting to try and find a way past for sixth position. Can he potentially get him down into this left-hander, which Hamilton's peeled off? Ricciardo defending the inside from Perez right now. Is Alonso able to get sixth? He doesn't look like he's close enough this time around, but he wants to try and get him on some more laps as he desperately can right now. So now around... around the right-hander we go, as at the moment Alonso still stuck behind Hülkenberg right now. So at the moment he's currently leading. At the moment he looks like he's going to try and attack him down into the last corner. Actually, Alonso tucking up into Hülkenberg's slipstream. Hülkenberg defending the inside. Is Alonso going to flick to the inside? No, not quite. At the moment, Hülkenberg keeps him on him, but can Alonso potentially get him down into turn one as Hamilton starts lap four, I think. Lap three of the race, and I think he set another fastest lap in the process. Meantime, look at Perez! Perez now down to the inside of Ricciardo! Can he get second place? Alonso's down to the inside of Hülkenberg right now! Perez down to the inside of Ricciardo! Can he get second of the Australian? Around the outside goes Ricciardo, and just about keeps second off Perez for now. Alonso still trying to find a way past Hülkenberg. Side by side to go. Through turn two to go. And has Alonso been able to get it? Through turn three. And Alonso moves up into sixth position. A great pass for the Spaniard. Perez down the inside of Ricciardo. And Perez moves up into second place. A great pass from Sergio Perez. Up into second place. Demotes Ricciardo down to third. And now Ricciardo's got to be wary of Pascal Wehrlein. Alonso's up to sixth. And now Vettel's got to be worried about him, because Vettel is Alonso's next target. And, wow, Alonso making it up to the field after a terrible qualifying session yesterday. But Hamilton just getting away from Daniel Ricciardo. And, well, where has this pace come from Lewis Hamilton? It has to be said, this team has been upgrading for quite a bit. And clearly, Lewis Hamilton, it's either the track or the car, he's clearly adapting to it pretty well. But he knows that probably Alonso is probably going to be gaining right now, because he's picking off people. He's starting to pick off people one by one right now, disposing of Hülkenberg first. But at the moment, Hülkenberg's keeping him honest right now. But it doesn't seem that Hülkenberg's close enough to maybe potentially make a pass. So now Hülkenberg's got to worry about Joseph Newgarden, who's clearly doing a good job right now in 8th position. Alonso around the double left-hander. As meantime, Wehrlein trying his best to get on terms with Daniel Ricciardo for that podium. So Ricciardo now, just like we saw with Marcello in the sprint race earlier today, dropping backwards now. He's now falling into the clutches of Pascal Wehrlein, who desperately needs to get his championship underway after two DNFs in Australia and Brazil. He wants to get a finish. A bit of a lock-up from Sergio Perez there. Around at the right-hander there. And, well, clearly, Perez pushing really hard. He wants to try and catch up to Hamilton as best as he can to potentially take the lead in this race. So now, around the final corner we go. And let's see if Wehrlein's now going to try and get onto the slipstream and potentially pass Daniel Ricciardo for the podium as we go down the pit straight now. As Van Dorn's out! Stoffel Van Dorn is out of the race! What's happened to Van Dorn? Where is he on the track? He didn't have a good qualifying because he got took out at the start. And there he is. He's got a transmission problem. Van Dorn out with a transmission problem. And what a shame for the rookie. For the first time this season, he is out of this race. He is out of the Bahrain Grand Prix. We're down to 21 runners. Wehrlein trying to get onto the slipstream of Daniel Ricciardo. And confirmation there. And a little bit of a lockup from Wehrlein there. So he's also pushing as well into turn one. Has Hamilton now sets the fastest lap of the race, a 154.279. He's probably had to, because he realises that Perez is catching him right now. He's having to get his foot down. Alonso now down to the inside of Vettel. Can he get fifth off the German this time around then? Side by side go Vettel and Alonso. Down to turn one, rivals for 2 years in Formula One. Vettel trying to hang it around the outside. Side by side to go through turn two. This is going to be close, and Vettel just about keeps fifth. For now, brilliant racing between the two of them right now. Alonso's probably getting frustrated being stuck behind Vettel right now. And it's bringing Hülkenberg into this fight now. So Hülkenberg, who... That's Newgarden's out! Newgarden's out with a transmission problem! Newgarden out of the race! We're down to 20 runners! There's now only one Red Bull Audi in this race! Newgarden out of the race! That's his second retirement this season! And his season just goes from bad to worse! Joseph Newgarden still yet to score a point this season. And, well, what can you say about that? We're down to 20 runners now. Lewis is now the only Red Bull rider who could salvage points today. Newgarden out of the Bahrain Grand Prix as now around the right and left hander we go. Alonso still stuck behind Vettel as of right now. Vettel, you know, not going to let him through that easily. He knows Alonso's a quicker guy, but you know that Vettel will want to give him a lot of hard work. Want to make him work harder to get that position as they go around the double left-hander. Wehrlein still stuck behind Ricciardo right now. He's falling back a little bit. Maybe he's thinking in the long run. He might be thinking in the long run. Alonso is on a lighter fuel load compared to a lot of these guys. In fact, Wehrlein is as well. So maybe Wehrlein and Alonso have a plan right now. They seem to be lighter than most of the pack right now. They've even got a little bit... It looks like Vettel might be on a one stop, which could explain why he's probably potentially going backwards right now as they now come down the support pit straight. And so far, at the moment, Hamilton still leading here in Bahrain. Around the final corner we go. Hamilton has started lap 7 of 49. Can Alonso get him this time around? Somebody set the fastest lap. It was spotted briefly there. I don't know who it was. But now, down the pit straight, can Alonso take fifth? I don't think he's close enough this time around, so he's going to have to work a little bit harder to get Vettel for fifth position. As Rossi now is holding on to the final point after Newgarden's retirement. Meantime, Ocon, he's making a comeback from 17th on the grid. He's side by side with Max Verstappen for 11th. Side by side they go. Can the Scuderia get the first monster car, because one of them is holding on to that final top 10 position. Ocon down to the inside of Verstappen. Can he get him? These two were rivals in Formula 3 in 2014. And Ocon takes 11th from Max Verstappen. Next target for him is Kevin Magnussen. He's just one place away from the top 10. A little bit of a lock up there from Kevin Magnussen. Bottas moving up the field quite nicely. He's up into 14th after what happened at the start. So now, down the support pit straight. Hamilton again. Hamilton's flying right now. 154.224. He is not giving up. As Verstappen now defends the inside. Down the support pit straight. Bottas was getting close to him. And Verstappen's now going to be probably prone to Bottas. Bottas knows he has the quicker car compared to the monster. As they now go around the second to last corner. Is Bottas thinking of passing him? Down into the final corner. Down the back straight we go then. Heading into the final corner. He's going to the inside straight away. He didn't need the end of the straight. Verstappen didn't have enough time to defend. Down to the inside. And Bottas moves up into 13th position. A great pass. But can Verstappen potentially get him back down the straight? We've seen this in the feeder series. Can Verstappen get him back down the pit straight? He's tucking into the Eldorado slipstream. Is he going to look to the inside? No, he's not. He's going to tuck behind. And I think Bottas has done enough to claim 13th off the Dutchman. So, that's that. So, meantime, Rosberg now trying to make a comeback. Danny inside of Jensen Button. Can he get him down to the inside? Is Button going to hang it around the outside? Side by side they go. And Rosberg goes up to 18th. So, Rosberg mounting a fight back. Same as Massa. At the moment, he's got up to 16th, so he's managed, unseen by the cameras, to pass Danny Kvyat. And we're in the cockpit of Lewis Hamilton. And now, around the final corner, he will peel to the right of the track. He should do. Yes, there you go. So, into the pit comes Lewis Hamilton from the lead of this race. It will give Perez the lead. And let's see how quick it's going to be. He pulls into the first box. And let's see how quick it's going to be for Lewis Hamilton. So, let's see. So, it's going to be, they've done the tyre change. How quick is going to be? He's got 36.9 litres of fuel. So, is he fueled to the end of the race? I'm trying to think myself here. Yes, he is. He's fueled to the end. So Hamilton's on a one-stop. I'm going to presume everybody's doing the same thing. I think everybody's going to be doing a one-stop. Pagano now pits from ninth position. It seems that the one-stop around this track is the way to go right now. As Pagano now pits, he's fueled to the end of the race now. And, yeah, so that's that. So Pagano pits. Let's see where he's going to rejoin. How long is this stop going to be? It's a very long stop. Look at that. Very long stop indeed. An 18.4 second stop. Kvyat is now in the pits. So Kvyat's pitting now from 19th. And so into the pits he comes. So let's see how quick his pit stop's going to be. As at the moment, I'm going to presume Ricardo is going to be pitting pretty soon. This is a long stop for Kvyat as well. 18.6 litres of fuel being put in. Perez is pitting this lap, as is Daniel Ricciardo. And Fernando Alonso is. So Fernando's pitting this lap. So we're going to have the leader who will give the lead to, I think, Lewis. He'll give the lead back to Lewis Hamilton. As Magnussen's out. Kevin Magnussen is out of the race. What's happened to K-Mag? Where is K-Mag on the track? He was with Ocon. And I think we've lost him. Where is he? He was, in fact, I'm going to get to here. Because where is he? Have we missed him? I think we've missed him. He was in front of Ocon from what I remember. So let's see. Is he somewhere? Where are the yellow flags? Have we lost the yellow flags? Whatever the case, I think we've missed Kevin Magnussen. But either way, Magnussen is out of the race for some reason. We don't know what. The cameras did not catch on to him in time, which is unfortunate. Perez now dives into the pits from the lead of this race. Confirmation that Kevin Magnussen's out. Ricciardo now pits from second place. And that will give the lead now to Pascal Wehrlein, I think. No, sorry. It will in fact be, because Wehrlein's already pitted. I do apologise. I think. No, Wehrlein is actually leading. In fact, Wehrlein's pitting this lap. So let's see how quick Perez's stop's going to be. Well, not how quick it's going to be. Let's see how long. He's fueled to the end. So it seems that the one stop for everybody is the way to go. Alonso's in the pits, as mentioned, as is Ricciardo. And Perez has finished his pit stop. And he's still out in front of Ricciardo. Ricciardo just gets out in front. And Alonso's fueling for quite a while. Out he goes. And Hamilton has got back the lead from Perez, but Perez looks a little bit closer than what he did before. He rejoins in sixth in front of Ocon. He's got a puncher! Ocon's got a puncher and he's out! Esteban Ocon is out of the Bahrain Grand Prix! Such a shame after a great comeback and he's thrown it in disgust. We're down to 18 runners. Ocon is out of the Bahrain Grand Prix. What a shame. A puncher has taken care of that. Vettel is now the only scuderia out there. And you can even see it scraping on the floor as a result. So it's clearly damaged the suspension that badly if it's scraping on the floor like that. But Ocon is out of the race. Grosjean has now finished his pit stop. And we are expecting Wehrlein to pit this lap. So we're now down to 18 runners. And now around the third to last corner comes Wehrlein. He should be pitting pretty soon. And he is battling with Ricciardo, remember. So his stop is essentially crucial to try and get him on the podium. He's obviously going to be in the box for quite a while because it seems that everybody is going for the one stop. So around the last corner then comes Wehrlein. And he will peel into the pits. And there he goes then. So into the pits comes Pascal Wehrlein from the lead of this race, which he'll hand, I think, to Sebastian Vettel for now, who Alonso is currently battling with. So Wehrlein now pits from the lead. Let's see how quick his pit stop is going to be. And how quick it's going to be. He's fueled to the end. Let's see where he comes out in relative to Daniel Ricciardo, who he's battling with for that final podium. So let's see how quick it's going to be then. And that's a very quick stop, a 17.9 second stop, a good stop from the Etihad Mechanics. Where is Ricciardo? Ricciardo's just coming down the pit straight. It's going to be close. Has Ricciardo done enough to stay in front, or has Wehrlein managed to leapfrog him? I think Ricciardo's going to stay out in front, but how close is Wehrlein going to be? Side by side to go. I think they're side by side with each other. In fact, I think he might have done enough, actually. Wehrlein has leapfrogged Ricciardo, and Wehrlein will be in a provisional third place. A great stop from the Etihad Mechanics yet again from them. And Wehrlein has managed to leapfrog Ricciardo for a provisional third position. There's Magnussen's car. He pulled off down there, look. So, mysteriously, he was out of the race for some odd reason. But for now, that gives the lead to Vettel temporarily. the man who was on pole position. So a similar situation to what happened to Rozier in the feature race yesterday for GP2, as Button now pits from 15th. And, well, Wehrlein has managed to get the jump on Ricciardo. Great stuff from the Etihad Racing mechanics to get their man on a on a potential podium. So Vettel is going to be out here for quite a while, as is Hülkenberg. Rossi is going to be pitting this lap. In fact, could he make it to the end? Because look how much fuel he's got left. 0.6. I'm going to keep an eye on that. Let's see if he can make it. Rossi, down the back straight we go then. Has he pushed it too much? Let's see. Can Rossi just get it to the pits before it splutters to a halt? He's on 0.5 litres, 0.4 now. Flat out through the right-hander. Is Rossi going to make it? Let's see. Down the back straight, which is going to wear out the field just a little bit. 0.3 now. Let's see. Vettel now sets the fastest lap of the race. 0.2. Can Rossi just make it? 0.2 litres of fuel. I think he's just going to do it. Rossi now peels into the pit from third, just about making it to the edge there, wasn't he? So Rossi now pits from third. And that was tight indeed for Alexander Rossi. And so let's see how quick his pit stop is going to be. So, as we're on lap 19 of 49. Let's see where he's going to rejoin. He's fuel to the end. Let's see where he's going to come out then. So, he rejoins. He's done a 17.8 second stop, so around about the same time as Pascal Wehrlein did in the pits. So, let's see where Rossi's going to rejoin then. So, Rossi out of his box, and he's going to rejoin in 13th position behind his teammate Rosberg, who is actually pitting this lap. Rosberg's next target is actually Massa right now. So Alonso is currently in ninth, and he's got some work to do because he knows Vettel is still yet to pit. Meantime now, look at this. Bottas is on the back of Ricciardo, but we know Bottas is yet to pit, so Ricciardo doesn't have to worry about him too much. Meantime, Perez trying his best to catch up to Hamilton. He is closer than what he was during the pits, and we need to keep an eye on their gap. This will be first and second once the top two, which are the two Germans of Sebastian Vettel and Nico Hülkenberg, come into the pits. Meantime, Vettel, I wouldn't be surprised, as Hülkenberg's pitting this lap, so Hamilton will get up to second because Hülkenberg's pitting this lap. And I wouldn't be surprised if next lap, Vettel is also pitting. So, let's see. Is Vettel pitting next lap? Let's see when he crosses the line. He'll start lap 22 of 49. Let's see. Is he going to pit this lap? And he is. He's pitting this lap, and he sets another fastest lap, a 153.683. Vettel is flying right now. Hülkenberg pits from second place as he now pulls into his box. Let's see how quick his stop's going to be. He's going to hand second to Lewis Hamilton and third to Perez. So Hamilton will get some of their positions back. And once Vettel pits, they should be back in the lead, should Lewis Hamilton. And Hamilton's just coming down the pit straight, so he should be out in front of Hülkenberg. So Hülkenberg has now been fueled to the end of the race. And so, interesting stuff. So, coming out of the pit lane then, as Bottas now pits. So, Hülkenberg now rejoins in front of, in fact, as Verstappen's pitting. In fact, Hülkenberg has managed to get the jump on both Ricciardo and Alonso. So, as a result of them being held up by Verstappen, it's actually benefited Hülkenberg because he's gone out in front of these two. Oh my, so Alonso's got more work to do. What a shame. Bottas now finishes his pit stop as Ricciardo's teammate Massa pits. And in fact, Bottas and Massa being teammates in Formula 1 this year, but they won't be at the end of this year because Massa's retiring from Formula 1, not from motorsport. So I did kind of get get it slightly wrong because Massa could race for another category. So for now, by the way, George, if you still want Massa for next season, I'm not encouraging you, but he is still available. He's not actually retired from racing. I thought he was, but it's just Formula 1 after an article I saw. So, just be a remember of that. Meantime, looks like even Verstappen's now even challenging Ricciardo. This is mental. But then again, it could be explained because of the fact that Verstappen's carrying a little bit less fuel than what Daniel Ricciardo is right now, as they now approach the double left-hander on the track. Around the left-hander, they go. And meantime, as Vettel now pits from the lead. Vettel pits. Now, let's see what he's doing right now. He's been out there for a very long time. He'll hand the lead back to Lewis Hamilton. But where's he going to be in terms of Alonso? We know that these stops are going to be longer. Let's see. So, he's now fueled to the end of the race and he's finished his pit stop. And in fact, where is Hamilton? Hamilton's only just coming down the straight. Is Vettel going to rejoin in the lead? I don't think he is now because Hamilton's now coming down. But where is Vettel going to rejoin? This is interesting. Vettel is going to rejoin in front of Perez. Vettel has called the strategy right and he's now on the podium in front of Sergio Perez. Vettel is up into second place. A great strategy from the Scuderia Racing guys. Etihad are kicking their teeth right now. And it's just gone horribly wrong for them. Now, Alonso's got to do all the work to get up to him. Verstappen now pits. And now Alonso can now chase Ricciardo, who's only 1.4 in front of him. So, Alonso's now got to get his foot down. Verstappen now pits from what was 8th. Sorry, 7th. And so, he rejoins in 10th. And so, let's see where Verstappen is going to rejoin. And he rejoins in 11th place in front of Romain Grosjean. Just in front of him. So, just in front of Grosjean after the stop there then. So, Rosberg's in 15th. They're chasing down Mark Webber. Meantime, Vettel now in 2nd place. And now, look who he's got in his sights. Lewis Hamilton for the lead of this race. Vettel, after this clearly... The longer fuel, the bit more fuel that he's had in his tank has clearly worked out. And now look, the top four are on the same straight as each other. All four different teams, might I add. Hamilton, Vettel, Perez, Wehrlein. It's Red Bull Audi leading from Scuderia Racing, from Eldorado Racing, and Etihad Racing. Wehrlein even has a chance of winning this race, for God's sake. This is going to be incredible. Alonso's got to make his way up the field if he wants to win this race, of course. He's still got plenty of time, of course, and he's not that far behind the leaders. But, well, strategy played out correctly there for Sebastian Vettel as he's rejoined in 2nd place. Good stuff from the Scuderia mechanics as now he's chasing down Lewis for the lead of this race. Let's see what the gap is like between Hamilton and Vettel as he comes down the pit straight now as it's 1.8 seconds, a rivalry which everybody wants to have in Formula One. And, well... it would be a good rivalry indeed. Perez currently in third, but he's got to worry about Wehrlein, who's catching him up at the moment. So, Wehrlein in fourth at the moment, still trying to catch up to Perez as best as he can right now. Alonso, what is the gap between him and Ricciardo? It's 1.8. So, he's struggling right now. Alonso is on this stint. This stint clearly not working out for the Spaniard right now. This is just unfamiliar territory for Fernando Alonso. As he comes around the right-hander then. So Hamilton then. Coming around the right-hander he comes. And Hamilton now coming down the hill. He will be worried about Vettel, who is absolutely charging to take the lead off him right now. Vettel around the left-hander he goes. And Vettel currently in 2nd place at the moment. And looking good at the moment. He is now going to challenge for this for the lead of this race. And well, who would have thought that after what happened at the start, you would expect Vettel to be up in this position after the pit stop. Incredible stuff. So now he has a chance to win this race and get on terms with Lewis Hamilton, and he knows he potentially has a quicker car compared to Lewis, and he's going to use it to good effect. Meantime, Alonso's still struggling to get on terms with Ricciardo. As of right now, Bottas currently 9th after his pit stop. We've got a yellow flag. Somebody's been lifted up. Who is it? Somebody's being lifted up. It's Rossi. Rossi is out of the race. Rossi is out of the Bahrain Grand Prix. We're down to 17 runners. And Rossi is out of what I think was a points position. So what a shame. So that puts Pagano now in the points. Simon Pagano's now in the points. And that is actually Bottas' next target. So Bottas is only just one place away from the points. Rossi out of the Bahrain Grand Prix. We're down to 17 runners. What a shame for Alexander Rossi. Meantime, Vettel around the final corner. Let's see what the gap is like between these two then. So, Hamilton starts lap 25 of 49 in this race. Let's see what the gap is like between these two as they approach turn one. The gap is 2 seconds, actually. 2 seconds is the gap that covers them. So Hamilton has decided to get his foot down just a little bit on Vettel because he doesn't want him to get up close and potentially overtake him. Alonso, 2 seconds behind Ricciardo. So clearly, let's see, in terms of fuel, at the moment, they're running on about the same fuel at the moment. So Alonso, at the moment, clearly, maybe waiting out a little bit. Maybe he's thinking tactically. Who knows? But either way, this is not a good race for Fernando Alonso at the moment. Meantime, Rosberg is on the back of Webber on his fight back at the moment. As he just comes around the second to last corner. He comes down the back straight. We are approaching the 3 o'clock mark now. We're approaching 3 o'clock. Webber defends the inside of Rosberg as he approaches the final corner. And now, as Pagano's now out! Ooh, as I just mentioned him as well. It looks like nobody wants to be in the points. Bottas is now in the points. And there he is. Transmission problem. Pagano is out of the race with a transmission problem. What a shame. Potential first points have gone out the window. So now these two are battling for 12th. Now, as now, looks like Rosberg's going to take 12th off Webber. Side by side he goes. BMW S1 engine versus the Mugen Honda engine. Side by side they go. Can Rosberg take 12th? We're down to 16 runners. Danny inside. And Rosberg, Bubba's your uncle, takes 12th off Webber. Webber trying to fight him a little bit, but Rosberg able to hang it around the outside. And he's up into 12th position. So, that puts Bottas now in the points. As Lewis at the moment still doing a good job fending off Vettel and all of his attempts to catch up. Hülkenberg looks like he's catching up a little bit. Ricciardo's managed to lap Chilton, and Chilton's not helping Alonso either. So Chilton being a little bit of a pain in the Ricciardo spun! Ricciardo has spun! Alonso's up to sixth! What happened to Ricciardo? He spun off! Let's see, we're running on board with Daniel Ricciardo! As he comes around the left-hander, he comes into here and understeers off, went a little too quick and spins right in for the Chilton Alonso. Luckily, both Max and Fernando did not hit him, but that has put Alonso up into sixth position. That was a gift for the Spaniard. Next target for Fernando is Nico Hülkenberg. Heading towards the final corner, Hamilton will start lap number 41 of 49, and Vettel, lap 41 of 49, he's on now. What's the gap between him and Hamilton as they now approach turn one on the track? 2.1 seconds is the gap between those two. And someone's put Perez! Perez has pulled off with an engine problem! That puts Verlon on the podium! Oh, what a shame for Perez! An engine failure has cancelled those plans of another podium! What a shame! Perez out of the race! That puts Verlaine on the podium! And that puts, I think, it's going to put Verstappen in the points, I think. Yes, it will. It put Verstappen in the points. So, Perez, well, you could say the fuel load for the... Wait, where's Vettel? Vettel's gone! Where's Vettel? Where is Vettel on the track? No! He's got a puncture! The same problem as Ocon! Vettel is out of the Bahrain Grand Prix! And heartbreak at Scuderia! A puncture has wrecked the plans of Vettel, taking his first ever win! What a shame! The man who started on pole is out of the Bahrain Grand Prix. That lifts Verlaine up into second, which could be a potential victory if Hamilton splutters to a halt. But, oh my God, that'll put Hülkenberg on the podium now. Alonso's up into fourth. So that's been handed to him on a silver platter, hasn't it? Button. And that's put now Grosjean in the points. So Hamilton coming around the final corner, and he's going to start 46 of the race. The fuel is getting critical for Lewis. I will say it now, if there's too many retirements, I will red flag it and just take it back to the lap, because clearly there's some sort of issue with fuel. So yeah, around turn two and turn three, and approaching the right hander we go. And right now, Alonso has actually been given the call to pit. So maybe people will pit. Yes, Hamilton's been given the call to pit. So no fears then. It looks like everybody's going to pit for one last time in this race. They have left it for these last few laps. We are expecting everybody to pit for fuel. So that's a blast of relief for everyone then. Everybody will be pitting for fuel, it seems, one last time. And Wehrlein will probably be pitting a lap later because he's still got a bit to burn anyway. So he'll pit a lap later. And maybe Hülkenberg as well. So we should see usual positions. But we are expecting everybody to pit one more time. So Hamilton, who has a decent lead on Wehrlein, so he should be fine. He might be able to keep the win then. So a blessed relief for everyone then, every team boss, to put one more pit stop in to fuel them to the end of the race, because they know they cannot make it on this fuel. So that's that. So we've got last minute action for the pit stop. Hamilton will be the first to pit then, as he comes around the final corner. He will dart into the pits. There he goes. Hamilton pits for one last time. Four laps to go in this race. He'll switch lap 47 of the race, I think. I might be wrong. Yes, it will. Wehrlein will continue, but he'll pit next time around. Yes, he will. He'll pit. Hamilton has pitted for some fuel. Hülkenberg stays out. Hamilton has pitted just a little bit of fuel in. Alonso pits now. This is madness on the last few laps of the race. People are pitting on the last few laps. Alonso pits. Let's see how quick it's going to be. 5.9 litres he's taking on. Let's see how quick it's going to be. It's obviously going to be a quick stop, obviously. And it is a 9.4 second stop from the mechanics right now. Bottas is not going to be pitting, but he won't be out in front of those guys. So Grosjean will be pitting, as will Ricciardo. So last minute pit action, it seems then, for these guys. So like I said, no fears. Hamilton then should be able to win this race. We have three laps to go in this Grand Prix. And what has been a chaotic... Hang on a minute. No, never mind. Ricciardo's pitting. I do apologise. Ricciardo's pitting this lap. Maybe this could help Alonso. Who knows? Alonso could use this as his advantage to potentially try and leapfrog Hülkenberg to get onto the podium. So Grosjean's now in from 8th place. We are expecting Wehrlein to pit. Grosjean pits from 8th position. So unlike what Ollie Rowland and Antonio Fuoco did in the last race, these guys are thinking better and pitting with a few laps to go. So Grosjean finishes his pit stop. He's going to be joined in 10th. Wehrlein will be pitting as well. Looked like he had a little bit of understeer coming through the second to last corner. We have 3 laps to go. Wehrlein will pit, as will Nico Hülkenberg. So Hamilton will retake the lead in this Grand Prix. He should retake the lead. So Wehrlein now pits from the lead of this race. Here he comes then, into the pit. And he hasn't finished yet, Sean. You've still got a few laps to go. So pit action, as Wehrlein has taken 4.9 litres of fuel. And he does a 10.3 second stop. Hülkenberg's in. And now Hamilton retakes the lead of this Grand Prix. He has 2 laps to go in this Grand Prix. People are rejoining from their boxes. Ricciardo's pitted. Where is Alonso? Alonso's coming down the pit straight. What's this going to do? Wehrlein rejoins in second place. Hülkenberg, where's Alonso? I'm struggling to find him. He's still behind Hülkenberg. So Hülkenberg still managed to get out in front. But now look how close Alonso is to Hülkenberg. Maybe 2-lap dash to get the podium for Fernando Alonso. Where's Ricciardo going to be joining all of this? Bottas now pits. And now Verstappen. Now he's going to be darting into the pits. As now... So Verstappen now pits. Everybody should be pitting. And now Hamilton leads this race with 2 laps to go then. So, Alonso, it does appear that that's going to be yellow for the remainder of this race. Wouldn't surprise me anyway. Alonso has one more chance to pit. Confirmation about all these guys that have just pitted. Hülkenberg, Bottas, and Ricciardo also pitted as well. Verstappen also pitted as well. So he's fueled up to the end now. Kvyat has also now pitted. So he's fueled up to the end of the race. Massa has also pitted. He's fueled up to the end of the race. Rosberg's also pitted. He's fueled to the end of the race. And as Hamilton comes around the left-hander. And in fact, come to think of it, I don't think Vettel would have made it to the end either, looking at his fuel, because he was around about on the same amount of fuel as Daniel Ricciardo. And I don't think Vettel would have made it either if he was still in the race. So Hamilton would have been fine either way. So... Hamilton now then, as he comes around the final corner, he's going to start the final lap of the race. Webber pits for one last time. Hamilton now pit is starting his final lap here in Bahrain. What a day it's been for Hamilton. He took the lead at the start. He was able to build it up, and despite some pressure from Perez and Vettel, and despite this little fuel issue, he was able to keep his calm and looks to be able to take his first win of the season and bring Red Bull Audi back to some form of glory here in Bahrain. Fantastic stuff from Lewis Hamilton. Verlaine looks like he's going to kick off his championship in the best way possible by finishing in second place. Alonso looks to be, will settle for fourth. He'll take that because I think he's done a good job either way. A good comeback from the Spaniard after what happened at the start with him. So a good comeback from him there then. But meantime, Hamilton. Well, what a result it has been for Hamilton. He clearly showed the pace today of that Red Bull Audi. Red Bull Audi, their new names are clearly back. And they're probably, it's clear that they want to mount a title charge this season. Around the right-hander goes Lewis Hamilton, the man who'll be driving for Etihad Racing next season. And by the way, in terms of the announcement of who his teammate will be, I made a mistake. It's actually going to be after the GP2 and GP3 qualifying sessions and the press conference, not the 23rd. So it's actually on the 21st. If you look on the Etihad's Twitter account, they've pinned it at the 21st of October, not the 23rd. I do apologise. It's actually this coming Friday they announce Lewis's teammate at Etihad Racing. So Hamilton around the second to last corner. He's coming down the back straight. A fantastic debut here in Bahrain. A crazy Bahrain Grand Prix. But in the end, Red Bull Audi are back. Lewis Hamilton wins the Bahrain Grand Prix. Congratulations to him and the Red Bull Audi team. Good on you, Lewis. Pascal Wehrlein kicks off his championship and finishes in second place. Great stuff from him there. Hülkenberg is going to pick up his second ever podium in IFMC. Alonso close behind in fourth. He'll take that. He still leads the championship at the end of this. Good stuff from him there. Ricciardo is going to pick up his first ever championship point in IFMC. He's going to finish in fifth position. Well done, Daniel. Fifth for Daniel Ricciardo. Great stuff from him there. Bottas, after an amazing comeback, he's going to kick off his championship as well. He's going to cross the line in sixth position. Down the back straight he comes then. Bottas, he's going to come towards the final corner. And so down the pit straight we go. And Bottas is going to cross the line in sixth position. Position as Chilton retired on the last lap. What happened to him? He should be classified anyway. There he is. And he ran out of fuel. He didn't pit. So Chilton, stupidly, I should point out, didn't pit for fuel. So Chilton has made a a costly hour, but luckily for him, he wouldn't have affected him anyway. He will finish 90% of the race distance. Bottas crosses the line in 6th. Verstappen is going to pick up more points in 7th. Good on him there. Confirmation Max Chilton, the other Max, is out of the race. Verstappen crosses the line 7th. Massa, as Grosjean has also retired with suspension failure. So it's all kicking off. Grosjean out with suspension failure. What a shame. He should complete 90% of the race distance. So Massa is going to pick up his first points this season after what has been a tricky start for him indeed. Massa crosses the line in 8th. Rosberg crosses the line in 9th. But there you go then. So after all of that, Lewis Hamilton is back on the top step of the podium. Great stuff from him there. And it's been one chaotic Bahrain Grand Prix. So, after all of that, here is the results of the Bahrain Grand Prix. Lewis Hamilton won the race with Pascal Wehrlein in second place. Nico Hülkenberg third, with Fernando Alonso fourth. Daniel Ricciardo fifth. Valtteri Bottas is in sixth, with Max Verstappen seventh. Felipe Massa rounds out the point in eighth. Nico Rosberg ninth. Romain Grosjean classified in 10th. Jenson Button 11th. Mark Webber 12th. Danny Kvyat 13th. Max Chilton classified in 14th position in the end there. So Grosjean and Chilton did classify because they did complete 90% of the race distance in the end there then. So, we scroll down to the rest of the field, and these are the retirements. And they are Sebastian Vettel, Sergio Perez, Simon Pagenaud, Alexander Rossi, Esteban Ocon, Kevin Magnussen, Joseph Newgarden, and Stoffel Vandoorne. They were the retirements here in Bahrain. A very entertaining Bahrain Grand Prix. We'll be right back.
3, 2, 1.